Hello, hello. How are you doing? How's your day going today? So we are about to dive into today's training for the Thrive Mastermind. And today's theme is all about productivity and batching. So this is one of my favorite topics to talk about for entrepreneurs who have one person, meaning you are the person doing it all. You are a one-woman show. This is going to be so impactful for you. Now, for those of you who already have a virtual assistant, or maybe you contract out a few projects here or there, guess what? This is also for you. It's going to help you to be extremely efficient in getting things done and maximizing your effectiveness. So we all know that we start with why. Now, for those of you, if this is your first time hearing me talk about the why, go back and catch a previous video. But Simon Sinek, who is an amazing author, he has a great TED Talk, Start With Why. He says, people don't buy what you do, they buy why you do it. Now, think about it. When we purchase from a brand, we're often looking at what are the company's values, or do they have a good reputation? Let me give you a practical example. Back maybe like a year or two ago, Uber had this big controversy and people started using the hashtag delete Uber and they were using Lyft instead. It may seem like it was just a social media fad, but it was much more than that. Uber's values didn't align with what they were saying to people in public. As a result, Lyft, who was a by far competitor, not a close competitor, a far off competitor, gained so much traction that it actually changed the ride share industry. So going back to my point of Simon Sinek, people don't buy what you do, they buy why you do it. People believe in the company's value. And it's so much so that it changed an entire industry when we think about the competition between Uber and Lyft. It actually has decreased the value of Uber's stock, increased the value of Lyft, and as a result, the long-term implications that economists are projecting are saying that Uber will not reach profitability in part because of the backlash they experience for not being true to their values. So when it comes to batching, bringing it back to our topic of training today, when it comes to batching, you want to be as efficient as possible with your time so that you can focus on the things that matter. We all know that when we're running our businesses, things will come up. So how do you stay focused on doing the things that you are passionate about, things that are core to your brand, but doing all of those other things? Now, when you're just starting out or maybe you don't have systems and processes in place, it's easy for you to start putting out fires. You will let the day run you instead of you running the day. Now, in Thrive Mastermind, we have a lot of members who have a 9-to-5 and they're starting their business on the weekend or in the evenings they're running their business. Batching is just as important for you as it is for those full-time entrepreneurs. So what is batching? Batching is where you take a similar group of tasks and you complete them together. You actually schedule the complete tasks together. So I want you to think about this. There's something called brain switching, the time that it takes your brain to switch from one task to another. And with that, you got some ramp up time. You gotta get in the zone pretty much. Now, I read a study by Harvard Business Review that said people who drive with lack of sleep, they are worse off than those people who drive with alcohol in their system and worse off than those people who smoke a substance and they drive. Now, I'm not talking about cigarettes. I'm talking about marijuana. So just to be clear there. And this isn't that debate. So just keeping to the facts of the report here. So what it means is that when we're sleepy, we are deeply deprived. When we're multitasking, we're operating at the least optimal level. And when you're operating at your least optimal level, guess what? You are not doing your best work. You probably aren't focused on your why, the reason why you're doing what you're doing. So when matching comes into play, you're able to bucket these different activities that will help you reach your company goals, doing all of the things that you need to do. And so matching is your tool to keep your brain from switching between tasks, that downtime, and it helps you to get more done in essentially a shorter time span. So again, today's training, I just told you what batching is. That was our first step. Now I'm going to tell you how to use batching, and then I'll give you a few examples. So batching right now for me, it works because it reduces my startup and slowdown time. For instance, in the day-to-day activity of ZeroGap, which is the company that I am the founder of, ZeroGap.co. At ZeroGap, we curate leadership, learning, and development solutions for companies in male-dominated industries. That's our why, to close the leadership gap. Now, inside of closing that leadership gap, there are lots of things that we need to do. We produce a lot of content because we're curating content as well. We're reviewing books, podcasts, conferences, etc. The list goes on and on. We're also working on contracts, we're responding to clients, we're actually hosting these trainings, whether we're traveling to a client or hosting them at our downtown Dallas office. So what you can begin to see here is the to-do list is really long for all of the things that we have to accomplish. So how do we bring that back in and maximize the time that we have? So when it comes to reducing our startup and our slowdown time, we want to make sure that when we're going into an activity, we're going into that activity with the most clarity as possible and with the least amount of distraction. So the second reason why batching is so helpful, not only one, it helps you reduce that startups and wind down time, but it reduces your daily clutter. So what I brought to our training today is, for those of you who are watching the video, I know some of you will be listening to audio only. This is my handy dandy notebook that I use for day-to-day business activity. So I didn't plan that, but as you can see, a ton of stuff has just fallen out of my day-to-day notebook. That's called clutter. And there's not only physical clutter, there's digital clutter. So if you're scrambling through emails, if you're flipping through to find things, that is clutter. So instead of having seven individual times where I'm going to go and write an email, I use batching to help cut down on that, where I have too many times where I'm writing emails. Or another favorite thing about reducing clutter is drive time. Now, in Dallas, I don't drive that much. I use Uber for everything. I live in a very centrally located area. Love, love, love my neighborhood. And so what that allows me to do is, it's like 2 miles to get to my office. On a good weather day, I might walk to the office. On a regular weather day where it's hot in Texas, I'm going to Uber. So instead of me having a lot of clutter in my day, just having downtime when I'm commuting to the office, I use my Uber time to record videos, video content that I use to connect with my audience. I'm just giving you an example of how I reduce my clutter. Now, back to my notebook. How do I reduce clutter with this? This is the second reason why batching is important, is it helps me to stay organized and find the things that I need to in the most efficient time manner. And the third reason why batching can help you is it improves your focus. So as you work on a task longer, you begin to enter your flow. And your flow is the state of your mind where your work becomes easy and your distractions, they just float away because you are in the zone. So successful batching is, it's like a meditation for your work, per se. You know, when you meditate, you're in the zone, you're focused, you have eliminated all other distractions. And that's something we say at ZeroGap all the time, eliminate excuses. We also eliminate distractions. So with that, batching does help you to eliminate some of the distractions that pop up in your day-to-day. So we talked about what batching is. I just gave you three reasons why batching is important. Pardon me there. So now I want to give you some tips on how to start batching. Now, throughout our conversation, this training this morning, I just shared with you morning or afternoon. Y'all don't hold me to that. It's 5 o'clock somewhere and it's 6 a.m. somewhere, all right? So let me give you a couple of tips of how to start batching. And these are just things for you to consider. There's no one-size-fits-all solution when it comes to batching. So consider how you want to incorporate this into your lifestyle, given your personal responsibilities as well as your professional responsibilities. I know some of you are moms. Some of you are working a 9-to-5, and then you're working on your business from 5 p.m. to 9 p.m. and on the weekends or maybe even later. So I want you to, as I go through this list, think about what's going to be the solution that's going to help you to maximize your time to get things done so that you can focus on your why. Now, let me pause here. Homework assignment. For any of you who has not seen the TED Talk with Simon Sinek, and Simon is S-I-M-O-N, Sinek is spelled S-I-N-E-K. The TED Talk is called Start With Why, and there's also a book. So I want you to go back as your homework and watch that if you haven't, because again, everything that you're doing, you're being intentional about, and you're starting with your why. So let's hop into these tips. I have 20 that we're going to go through in this training. So if you don't have your notebook handy, please pull out your notebook, because you'll definitely want to jot down notes. You can come back to this recording at any time in the training just to get a refresh on anything. Email. So there's a book by Tim Ferriss. It's called The 4-Hour Workweek. And in it, he says that he gets like 300 or more emails an hour. And so that's as a result of having a best-selling book. So he got a lot of attention and people just started emailing him. So with that, he started to have to respond to a large amount of emails. What he decided to do was respond to emails twice a day. Now, you probably emailed me, if you're in the Thrive Mastermind program, we've emailed each other several times, and you've got an auto response that says, hey, my workload is busy. We're busy right now. We'll get back to you at, I forget the exact times, but I think it's noon at 3 p.m. Central Standard Time. I got that tip from Tim Ferriss's book, The 4-Hour Workweek. Now, before I read Tim's book, I used to do something similar. And this is back when I had a traditional 9-to-5, when I was a contractor at the Center for Disease Control. What I used to do was I did not check my email first thing in the morning. And I didn't realize I was doing batching then. I didn't have the language to it. But this is a tip that has worked so great for me that I transferred this email habit to my business. So back to the example from when I worked a traditional 9-to-5. I would, before I would leave for the day, Monday through Friday, I would print out my calendar for the next day. I would also have a 3-point to-do list. So the top 3 things that I needed to accomplish that day. So when I would come into work the next morning, I already had my schedule as well as the things that I needed to accomplish. And I did not check email for the first hour of my day. Because oftentimes when you start checking emails first thing in the day, you go into reaction mode. So instead of controlling your day and running your day, you're letting the day run you, you're letting emails run you, and all you're doing at that point is just responding, 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 responding. And you've got to move out of that zone. That's no way to operate a business. That's no way to increase your productivity. So where batching comes in is, batching allows you to respond to emails several times a day if you want. Yes, for some people, they've decided to use email batching to respond to emails once a day. Now, I see stats that say people pick up or touch their phone over 100 times an hour. How is that even possible? But it is. So, given that stat, it's really important that if you're checking social media or you're checking your emails, to put some constraints on it so that you can stay in the zone and stay focused. So for you, I'd like you to consider, how can you email batch? Can you respond to emails 1 to 3 times per day? Will that help you to stop responding and to stay in the zone and to get things done. Now, the second thing is reading. I am an avid reader. I read 5 to 7 books per month. You all know that because I'm always sending you book recommendations. And if you missed the last set of book recommendations, they're always on my LinkedIn profile. So when you read, here are a couple of tips of being productive and batching, I should say, with books or articles. Set a scheduled time where you're going to read. So it could be first thing in the morning, it could be during your lunch break. If you have a longer commute, you may be an audiobook person, you need to do that. Instead of talking on the phone or just listening to music, and music is important, I love music, I love to dance, figure out a way to incorporate your reading time, that consuming of vital information, incorporate that into your commute. That's just an example of batching. So not only are you driving to work, you're also consuming information. Now, different things are gonna work for different people. Another tip that I use for reading is long form articles that I have. When I'm traveling, what I do is if there's something that I look at and I see it's a long article, but I know it's something I wanna read, I look at my calendar and I say, okay, on this date, I'm going to be traveling. I know if I get to the airport in the appropriate amount of time to go through TSA, I will need to be sitting at the airport waiting to board and then to take off. So I go to that time of day and I pull up my calendar and I insert the link of whatever I'm going to read into my calendar. So it will come up as an alert while I'm sitting at TSA. I can pop it up, or as I'm sitting at the airport, it pops up. I just open it. I have that to read. I schedule that on my travel days. And that's just another way to batch, to maximize your productivity. So blogging. For those of you who blog or vlog, if you have a podcast, a video channel that you have on YouTube in terms of content for your business, or you have a business blog, make use of your blogging platform's timestamp feature. So this way your post will be ready days before it goes live. Now with batching, you want to try to think as far out as possible. There's a podcast that I listen to. The host is John Lee Dumas. And what John does is John records his podcast like 3 months in advance. So when he takes a month off from work, no big deal. He has so much content in the pipeline that it does not affect his business. And then when he's away, those podcast episodes are already scheduled and ready to go. So when we're talking about blogging, using your timestamp feature, there are some things that you can schedule in advance. You can schedule your YouTube videos to be released on a certain day when you upload from the web browser. You can schedule your Facebook and Instagram posts through Facebook. You can schedule LinkedIn posts, Twitter posts through a service like a Hootsuite or MeetEgger, any of those social media platforms that handle your scheduling. And additionally, if you're using Pinterest, you can use the tool Tailwind, or Pinterest has a feature that allows you to schedule. So what I typically do for social media posts and blogging, I'm going to put in that social media bucket. What I typically do is at the first of a month, I already have a list. Well, at the end of a month, for the next month prior, I already have a list of content that I've already created. So what I do is I repurpose the content. For Zero Gap, we have a podcast called Power Banking. So with Power Banking, we sometimes have videos. So those are scheduled to be rebroadcast to people the next month because not everyone is on social media at all times. We know that. And for those people who do see our posts, Facebook research tells us that people need to see, when I say they, I mean our target audience, they need to see content or a call to action at least 3 times before they make a move. So the reason why we batch content that we've already produced and shared, we schedule that the following month to go out at least 3 times. So the last date of the month, we already have the list of everything we've created that day. We use our tool for Zero Gap. We use Hootsuite. We go into Hootsuite and we schedule the post to go out for the whole month. So when we look at the calendar, we look at the full 30, 31 days, whatever, however many days in that month, and we make sure we have at least 3 posts on the calendar per day for the entire month. So let me take a step back. When it comes to blogging batching, we also recently had a launch of the latest best-selling book that I wrote. It's called Don't Leave Money on the Table, Negotiation Strategies for Women Leaders. So as I was going across the country during book signings on the book tour, I didn't have time, and my team was busy shipping books. We didn't have time to be on social media every day. We had more than 3 posts during our launch calendar related to the book so that things were going out as we were doing other activities. So when you look at your month in advance, at your blogging schedule or your video schedule or your podcasting schedule, go ahead and schedule time to record those activities in advance, but then on the back of that, schedule a day where you can go in and you can timestamp up at least 1 month in advance so that you can get ahead of your social media calendar. Now, let's move on from social media. I could talk about this all day because marketing is close to my heart. I started my career in advertising and marketing. And fun fact, I don't think I've shared before, when I was in college as a marketing student, I was vice president of the American Marketing Association chapter on my school campus. So just a little nugget of why I love marketing so much. So the next thing on our list, number 4, phone calls. In your business, relationships matter. People do business with people they like. Even if you have an online business, you're gonna have to communicate with people over the phone from time to time. So with phone calls, keep a list of all the people you need to call and empty that list once per day. So one of the things I love is when you're staying in a hotel a lot, like I am, you get these little notepads that are on the desk. I typically write out things on that list, but it is a small piece of paper. So when I have to do phone calls, not only do I use my electronic calendar, I also use a little paper file that helps me to keep a list of all the people I need to call, and I empty that out once per day. So what I do is I make all of the phone calls that I need for that day. I try to do them all within a certain time frame, or I'll do phone calls twice a day. Because if you're interrupted by phone calls in and out of your day, what that means is you're going to have to stop doing something, and it goes back to that startup, that ramp up time, and that wind down time. Now for Zero Gap, because one of our services is leadership coaching, where we work with women leaders in male-dominated industries and coaching them on their leadership journey, we have certain days of the week that we allow for coaching. So that way, again, we're batching an activity to a full day. So we typically do coaching calls on Mondays and Thursdays, and during some seasons, we'll do Monday, Wednesday, and Thursday. So that way, our attention, we have not only days that we do phone calls, but we have hours within those days so that we can do other activities as well. So doing your calls in one batch will give you more freedom, and it will help you pick the times of day when people are less busy. Now, for those of you who are in consulting with your business, I will tell you this. If you're working a 9-to-5 and you have coaching or consulting services that you're offering, you have to think about your schedule for your workday. And in terms of batching, because potentially your consulting clients or your coaching clients are also working during the day, you may offer extended hours in the evening, or you may want to start earlier in the morning. Now with Zero Gap, this is what we do full time. So we have batched our time where we can do coaching calls with our leadership clients as early as 6:30 a.m. We make sure we're available during the lunch hour as well as the evening. So we rarely have coaching calls like 9 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. and then from like 2 to 5. We rarely have coaching calls during that time. Sometimes we do, but not often. And that's just another example of batching. This one, number five, is important because we have to have work-life integration and you gotta have time to recharge. So entertainment. When you are batching your leisure time, try to batch that in a way where you're doing these things at once, where you get motivated to finish your work early, or if you're an early bird, you do your entertainment in the evening, but find a time where it really gives you joy, a chance to relax instead of procrastinating. So one of the things that I like to do is use entertainment, my entertainment time, as a reward for getting things done. So if I have a really challenging contract that I need to review or a negotiation that I'm involved in, I'll schedule my entertainment right afterwards as a form of batching. So that is my reward. Now, number six, assignments. Whenever I need to write an article or work on a project, I try to do it in one setting. Now, this means spending several hours in one day to complete an assignment, but this also saves me the procrastination guilt. If you are continuously thinking that I need to get this done, you're creating anxiety in yourself. So Brian Tracy has this amazing book. It's called Eat That Frog. Now that's our second reference today. The first book I shared with you was the book Start With Why by Simon Sinek. Our second book is Eat That Frog. Now with Eat That Frog, he says, do the thing that you're dreading the most first thing, get it out the way, and move on. So any assignments or tasks that you have, try to schedule those first off and do it in one setting. Don't break it up 1 minute here, 3 minutes here. Get it all done. And then if you need to go back and do an edit afterwards, that's fine. And then do all of that in one setting. The sixth way to batch is computer work. So batch all of your computer work into one part of the day and then go wireless for the rest of the day. So when I say wireless, I'm using that as a metaphor to say you have to unplug. You have to give your brain time to recharge. So any activities that you have to do on the computer, try to do them together, then give yourself a break. Number eight is online magazines or article reading. If you are in the business where you have to look at content daily, maybe the example that I use of putting it on my travel days, maybe that doesn't work for you. If you're in a business where you have to constantly be on top of things. So if you have to look at articles or online magazines or newspapers each day, schedule that in a batch time, either several days a week or at a certain time of day. Number nine, cleaning. So for me, my favorite thing to do with cleaning is there are certain things I do around the office or home where I have to do some things to tidy up. But at other times, one of the things that I love to engage in is using a cleaning service. I'm gonna just put this out on the table. Most of the people who consume my content, you're women traditionally, and women are the ones who clean. Guess what? Hire a cleaning service, keep it moving, use that time to do something else, and you can take back some of your time to dedicate another area. 10 is shopping and running errands. Try to batch that together. So for groceries, another hack that I use is I use a grocery delivery service. I have an Amazon Prime membership, and that gives me access to Amazon Fresh. What I do with that is I order my groceries online and I know they'll be delivered to me in the window that I choose. So I just spend time online or on my phone picking the things I want. And then I go about my day and move on to my next task, and then those are delivered to my home. So that's another time saver. But if you enjoy shopping, cut down on your gas bill and do all of your grocery shopping and your dry cleaning and your visits to the post office all at the same time. That's a batching activity. So that rolls us into number 11, cooking. For me, cooking is a source of joy. So if I'm going to cook, you've probably seen people on social media share that they do meal prep. I will try to cook several meals in a half a day, and I don't mind eating leftovers, so I'll just pack them up in those containers, and then I'll have several meals. That is a way for me batching so that I can get up and go when I'm hungry, when I'm busy. I don't have to order Uber Eats as much because I already have a meal that's ready to go that's healthy and prepared. And we're going to have an expert come on to the Thrive Mastermind to talk to you all about the importance of eating healthy and the types of food that you should be eating so that you can stay productive. So that's going to be coming up soon with Thrive. So you definitely want to make sure you're on that session live to ask any questions of our friend Shireen, who is the CEO and founder at Yumlish, so that you can optimize your health and your productivity through the foods that you eat. Moving along in our batching lesson today to number 12. So as you're building your business, there are times where you have to take a class, whether it's an online class or an in-person class. Try to schedule those in a day where it's going to give you the least amount of disruption to your lifestyle. So if you're doing an online class, where's the time where you're going to have a limited interruption, where you can sit there and focus on the content and actually consume everything so that you don't have to watch a video twice or watch it three or four times because you had so many distractions, you only caught bits and pieces. If you're traveling to a physical location for a class, think about the other activities you can do during that time so that you're optimizing your time and batching. Number 13, so free time. So compress your work into 6 days and give yourself, actually what I like to do with my free time is I like to start my day when I get to the office about 10 a.m. and then leave at 3 p.m. That gives me time to run my errands. I'm not in the midst of any rush hour traffic at all. And so with you, with your free time, you can do something similar. So what I know that I'm going to have is I'm going to have between 4 and 5 p.m. if I'm doing coaching calls as free time. So I can get a hair appointment in, a nail appointment, a massage, anything like that in terms of my free time just to recharge, relax. And if I want to take a jog or anything, I can do it during that free time period. Now, 14 is really important for batching, and this is scheduling time to think. So thinking with limited interruptions is something that we all have to work on, is scheduling that time to wind down and think. So I schedule twice a day, and the way I've been able to enhance my thinking time is just using meditation. 15, planning. This is so important. Planning. So set aside several hours to plan out your next big goal or your next big idea. So planning in bits and pieces is the best way to ensure that you're going to procrastinate. One of the things that we do for our Thrive members who book with the enhanced feature is I meet with them not only in the group setting once a month, but I meet with those people continuously one-on-one outside of our group trainings, and we go through a planning session. So typically what that looks like is we'll hop on a Zoom call, and we'll go for about an hour, and we just go through their plan, and we talk about the execution strategy, and get all of that out of their head. Because what we found to be helpful with plans is you need an action plan. You just don't need the dream and hope that things are going to come together. You have to map out what you're going to do. Now, does that mean you have to have it all figured out to get started? Nope, absolutely not. But you do have to get started if you're going to make progress. Otherwise, you'll procrastinate and you'll never get things done. So sleep. Here's your third book recommendation. The third book is Thrive by Arianna Huffington. Yes, that's the name of our mastermind, but it's also the name of the book. So Arianna Huffington, in her book, really gets into the science of sleeping, of why sleeping is so important. And with sleep, here's the thing. Sleeping is something that our society hasn't talked enough about. People pride themselves on saying that they're busy. Oh, I'm so busy, I'm doing this. I'm so busy, I'm doing that. And we almost wear it as a badge of honor. But when we get burnt out, it's horrible. It can lead to sickness, it can lead to frustration, and it can impact our personal and professional lives, and especially our businesses. Because if you are so tired where you're just like, I can't even, then that is going to show through in how you serve your clients and how you lead the people you're working with on your team. So get enough sleep. I don't know how many hours a night you need. I'm not a sleep expert, but I will say this. I know myself, and I know for myself, I need between 7 to 8 hours a night to function properly. So how many hours do you need, and what can you do to ensure that you're getting uninterrupted rest? Now, because I have a really flexible schedule, on days where I travel a lot, those next few days when I'm back in the office, I might work from home just so that I can get a nap in the middle of the day to recharge. And with that, sleeping, we talked about cooking earlier, drink lots of H2O. So I get alkaline water delivered with my groceries from Amazon because that's the best water for me to drink. And that forces me to consistently drink that water. When I'm on the road and I can't find alkaline water, I will have a lime. So this is just a side hack. I squeeze the lime to get all of the juice out and then pour it into my water because someone told me, some health expert told me that lime is a natural alkaline infuser. So just passing that along. Number 17. So number 17 is a money day. As a business owner, you have to look at your numbers. You have to look at what you're dedicating your resources to. And it doesn't matter how much money you're making in your business, and you all, the goal is to make a lot of money. Side note, do not say I'm not doing this for the money with your business, because you need money to live. You need money to buy food. You need money to pay your bills, to have a house to live in, to buy clothes, to do the necessary things. So it's one of my pet peeves when women say, I'm not in business for the money. I'm in business to do good. Listen, ladies, you can be in business to do good and make money, but you're not doing anyone any favors if you have to borrow money, if you're not bringing in enough cash flow into your business. So have a money day in terms of batching where you specifically look at, and this can be once a month or it can be once a week, you'll know the type of cash flow that you have coming into your business, and you need to look at the numbers. Do you have any reoccurring subscriptions? How much are you charging your clients for your products? And how much, if you're selling widgets, and I'm just using widgets as a generalization, but if you're using widgets, how much are they costing you? And break down that cost very specifically. Stay on top of those numbers. And then look at all of the costs associated with running your business and how much money you're bringing in. And you should be reviewing how much your products and services cost to make sure that's appropriate for, one, your industry. You want to be competitive, so look at what your competitors are doing as well. But have a money day where you take time to go in and deep dive on all of your expenses. So looking at your bank fees, your credit card fees, and again, those monthly subscriptions for businesses, whether it's your video conferencing service, your business cell phone provider, your office-related expenses, stay on top of those numbers. At minimum, you need to be having one money day a month. Now, for those of you, your businesses has already transitioned into the 5, 6, 7-figure months, you want to have more frequent money days. And if you want to go into more detail of how you operate a money day, shoot me a message, and we can cover that in one of our Thrive one-on-one sessions if we need to look at the one-on-one money part of your business. And also bring in, on that note, bring in your financial advisor or your accountant, your CPA, whoever you're using for the business. Shout out to Thrive Mastermind member Teresa, because Teresa's business is an accounting service, online bookkeeping, and consulting for those online-based businesses whom you need a CPA, you need an accountant. She has a whole system and process to help you get your business life together and thrive. So, number 18 on our list, just a few more left, social contact. So, cut down on how many interruptions you have. I remember distinctly when I moved from a traditional 9-to-5 to owning this business and working this business full time, people used to randomly call me and say, oh, hey, I can't go to this today, or my kid is sick, can you come over and watch them? Or they would just really be genuinely curious, like, so what do you do all day? And I'm like, I work just like I used to work, but now I'm doing it for zero gap. So for those of you who have that transition from your traditional 9-to-5 to your own business, eliminate that social contact during your work hours. For those of you who are still working your 9-to-5 and you're running your business from 5 p.m. to 9 p.m. and on the weekends, this is even more important for you because your time is of the essence. So this means you're going to have to cut down on dinners, on happy hours, on weekend brunches, on trips with your friends, and dedicate that time to your business. But again, everything in balance and moderation. So when you do go to dinners and when you do happy hour or weekend brunch, you want to batch that time so that you're staying productive and staying in alignment to get things done. Now, number 19, a productivity system. Batch all of your to-do lists, your inboxes, and your forms into one convenient location. So important for me to say this. Don't be a digital hot mess, meaning, oh, I use this over here, I use this over here, I use this over there. Sometimes it's necessary, but more often than not, there are so many tools to help you with running your business where you can do multiple things in one house. So in a previous training for Thrive, we talked about how you can use Square to optimize your business. Not only can you send invoices and receive payments, but if you're selling products, you can sell them through the online store. Having everything in one house instead of checking 6 or 7 websites, this is especially helpful when you go through on your money day and you're looking at your cash flow. If you're centralizing your payments into one location for different products and services, you're able to easily pull reports and analyze that data versus spending half of your day pulling reports from 3 or 4 different websites. Similarly, they're like the to-do list websites. So for me, I am using Zoho, and Zoho has been very helpful, but I know other people who use different tracking systems for their business. So find the one that works best for you and implement that in. Now, our 19 is the administration part of your business. This really needs to be something that you batch in every day, even if it's a 30-minute segment. And then, I'm sorry, that was 19. The productivity systems, 19 also includes that administration. And 20, whether it's your website statistics or your social media analytics, you need to be digging into those numbers. So what gets measured is what gets tracked, what gets monitored, what gets enhanced, what gets improved. You need to be looking at your analytics on the platforms that are most important to you. So find a time to batch that in. You can do that under productivity if you like. So I know I just went through 20 things. If you need to go back, rewatch this training, re-listen to the training, but the thing is there's not a one-size-fits-all solution. That's why I gave you 20 options. Find the things that are going to work for your lifestyle or your business and start implementing those batching into your daily schedule. So what we did today in today's training, I told you about batching, of what batching is, and then I told you why batching was important. And then in our final segment of today's training, I went through and I shared with you different ways to use batching in your business. So we're going to move into our Q&A live segment next. And so that's the end of this training recording. And then any questions that you have, we're going to get that in our next part in the live Q&A. And I can't wait to celebrate with you and talk about your wins. So again, my name is Jacqueline Twilley, the leader of your Thrive Mastermind, president at ZeroGap.co, and I cannot wait to hear how batching helps enhance your business.